Hello students, welcome to CA session. Students, today we will continue the same chapter, chapter 1, Internet Basics. Students, earlier we studied about Internet, its components and about www. Now today we will study about various Internet terminologies. These are the basic terms used related to Internet. So students, first of all we will study about client. Client means any computer over the network. If there are so many computers connected in the network, then a single computer is actually a client computer and it is used to send a request from one computer to another computer if there is internet in our computer. Okay? So wherever the websites are kept, that is the server, the main computer. So a client computer will send request to the web server, that means to the server. So now server. So what is server? As I already told you, it is a main computer. Okay, when there is a centralized network, then all websites are kept on the server. So it is not actually only the web server, there can be a file server, email server, etc. So computer that receive request from the client computer. Okay, client computer will send request to the server and server will receive the request of the client computer and will respond to it. Okay. So web server respond to the web related request. If we have to visit any website, we have to use the web browser. Web browser will be the web client and there will be a web server to which web browser will send the request. Okay, so web server will send the respond related to the web page request. Now web pages. So any page that you are able to see on the web browser, a digital page, it can be document also. Nowadays you might have seen not only web pages, we are able to see audio, video, then PDFs, documents, presentation, Excel, everything we are able to see over the internet. So documents or pages that can be hosted over the internet are actually web pages. Now websites. Websites, collection of web pages, they are actually collection of interconnected web pages. They are actually designed on the basis of a specific goal. A topic is set in the mind first of all, and according to that the pages are designed and linked to each other to make website. Now, web portal. You might have seen Google, like when you type google.com in the web browser, what happens? Google web portal. On that single page there are so many links. From that link you can go to Gmail, you can go to Google Groups, then you can also see Google Images, Google Web, etc., Google News, Google Videos, etc. So that is a web portal. It will provide you 20 services. So it can be a website, it can be a service also that offers many resources like emails, forums, that means groups, and search engines, etc. So there are many web portals similar to Google, like MSN, Yahoo, Bing, Google itself, or India Times, etc. When you open their websites, or you will simply type google.com or yahoo.com or msn.com, then their web portal will appear. Now, web browsers. Web browsers are actually software. When I was discussing about client, I told you about web browser also. So web browser are actually software on the client computer. Okay, so that web browser will receive the information from the web server. Okay, like if we have to visit the website, we have to open a web browser, then in web browser we have to type the website name in the address bar. That website will be shown to us from the web server. So all websites are kept on the web server. Now there are examples of web browsers like Internet Explorer. It comes with Windows operating system. Then Google Chrome, we can download freely from the internet and we can use it. Firefox, then Netscape Navigator, Apple Safari, Opera, then UC browsers, then Link, etc. So now students, there are few more internet terminologies. Web client. Web client means the software that is on the client computer, that is on client side, and it is used to send the request and receive the request from the web server. Okay, so here the example of it is web browser. Then we have URL. URL full form is Uniform Resource Locator. Every website, every web page have a unique address on the internet, and that is URL. Okay, so if we have to open any web page or any website, we have to type in type address in the address bar, that is known as URL. Okay, we have to type the URL in the address bar of the web browser to open the website. Now, blog. So, blog is actually the short form of web blog. Earlier, it was known as web blog, then it becomes weblog, and then it becomes blog. So, here, it is actually online personal journal, we can say online diary of a person, or it can be a web page or a website of an individual where he can post his entries. Okay, he can post entries as well as he or she can update the entries also. So, the person who is blogging, that means the author who is writing the blog, that person is known as blogger. And blogging means the action of writing blog. If blogger is writing the blog, that means he is blogging. Then, newsgroup. Newsgroup is actually internet discussion forum. So, here users, those who are having common views, they can join the group, news group, and then they can share their discussion related to the common topic of interest. Now, students, in internet terminologies, we will discuss about emails. So, emails are actually electronic mails. Now, here we can send messages from one computer user to one or more recipients. These messages we can send to one or more people. And we should know their email addresses for it. Okay. It can be sent with the help of network, mostly with the help of internet. So, email address is required to send the email. So, every email has a unique address. Okay. Like if we have created any email, then we will be getting an email address. Now here, these are two parts of email addresses. These two parts are actually separated by a separator, that is @ symbol. The first part is known as username, then @ symbol will be there, and then you will be able to see host or a domain name. Okay, so it will be actually the host which on which you will be creating your email address. So students, I hope you understood this. Only this much for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.